हेलो फ्रेंड्स, नमस्ते। टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग मेनली लीनियर रिग्रेशन इन मैथमेटिक्स, हाउ इट इज बीन यूज्ड इन मशीन लर्निंग, एंड वी विल बी क्रिएटिंग वन रियल टाइम सिनेरियो यूजिंग प्योर मैथमेटिकल फॉर्मूलाज, एंड सेम वी विल ट्राई टू रिप्लिकेट इन आवर पाइथन कोड। वी विल वैलिडेट द रिजल्ट्स, and then at the last we will be using already some sophisticated algorithm that does the same thing that we did from scratch, the linear regression. Okay, so the question comes, why regression? Actually, regression is a broader concept. It's a method of modeling a target value based on independent predictors. Now, since here we are talking mainly about simple linear regression, so you can see on my screen, this is a typical simple linear regression example where I have y-axis and the x-axis, and we have plotted these blue lines are nothing but the data sets that has been plotted. So at given point of time, what x and y has the value, that has been plotted. So in linear regression, actually it's a simple machine learning model for regression problems. So that is when the target variable is real value. So it is good. It tries to derive the relationship, whether there is any linear relationship or not. So if you are new to machine learning, so it is good to get started with linear regression, because it's a very simple way that how pure mathematics is used to predict the future values. Okay. So based on this, I mean, as you can see, what we try to achieve through linear regression. So through linear regression, actually we try to create a model that tries to create a linear relationship between the input variable x, you can see here, this is my input variable x, and the single output variable y. More specifically, the y can be calculated from a linear combination of the input variable x. So let's say I have the data till this point, and I have the values from x, I can still predict the values from y because I have this much training data, and I can, by looking at the data, we can make the predictions that what the value of y will be based on the linear behavior of x. So now when there is a single input, let's say you have only single variable x, so this method is referred to as a simple linear regression. Let's say there are, in real life scenarios, you always have multiple features that needs to be predicted. So that time your multiple linear regression comes into picture. But as of now, we'll mainly focus on a single input, single feature that we will be explaining. Now quickly, I would like to summarize between how it really looks like in mathematics and in machine learning. So very important aspect that I will quickly try to cover. So long back, you might have studied in mathematics, very simple equation but very powerful, y is equal to mx plus c. So what does it mean? You might have forgot, so let me try to help you out. So the equation tells us y is nothing but the value that we are trying to predict. So we are trying to predict the value of y with an independent variable x. M is nothing but the, m is the slope of the line, and c is the y-intercept. So as we will again go back to below diagram, quickly we will show you. So as I said, we try to plot this line. This is best fit line, we call it. We try to plot it in such a way that it should touch maximum data points, that it should be nearer to it. So you can see, it may not be the perfect line, but it is very near to. So that is the motive of linear regression. And we keep on training our data in such a way until it touches almost all the points. Our data and the prediction should be intact. So again, coming to the concept now, as I said, y is equal to mx plus c. M is the slope of the line. So this is referred as the slope. What is the slope of the line? Is it horizontal, vertical, at what angle it is moving up? So that is called the slope of the line. C is the y-intercept. At what point of y it intercepts. So that gets derived from this c value. X, as I already said, it is a known number, and we are just trying to predict the y. So this is pure mathematics. And if you have to take the mean of x, that also I will explain in our example when we will discuss. Don't get scared with these big formulas. It is pretty simple. Even a schoolboy can do it easily. Now coming to the machine learning problem. In machine learning, we have a similar concept, same thing, nothing new, only the naming convention has changed. Your y slash y dash becomes b plus w1 x1, where w1 is nothing but here m was the slope of line, here w is the weight or feature 1. So it is nothing but the weight or slope is one and the same thing. When we say feature 1, feature 1 means when we have only one input. If we have two inputs, it could be feature 1, feature 2, same way. So here you were having the c as a constant, mx plus c. Here you have w1 x1, w1 is your slope or you call it weight here, and plus b, b is nothing but the bias or the y-intercept, sometimes known as w0. Some people pronounce it w0 plus w1 x1, something like this. So it is one and the same thing. This is completely the replica in machine learning. No extra things has been added, first of all. So you can have a look. In case, yes, before I forget, in case you need any such training material, like whatever data I have prepared, feel free to ask or put it in the comment section. Send me your email or you can put the comment. I will revert back and I will be sending the source code and the training material that I have created. This is purely for knowledge sharing purpose. So there will be no issues in sharing it. Now again, coming back, x is nothing but the feature. This is a known number. And y is the predicted label, the desired output. So what we are trying to do is f of y. Some people call it f of y is equal to b plus w1 x1. So here what we are trying to do is we are trying to predict the value of y based on the x. And we have to just only calculate two things to do it. Here y is equal to mx plus c. You have to calculate m and c. Same way here you have to calculate the weight and bias. And you will be able to draw your best fit line, the linear regression line. You will be able to check. So once your line is ready, so then we will talk about loss and other things. I would like to quickly now take you to a real life example. So let us consider a pure, don't get scared, we will go step by step. It's too simple, even you will be able to do it after completing this video. Let's say we'll consider a real time manufacturing again example. So here what we are saying, if a machine is running for so and so hours, we are seeing the offset of, or the it is going away from the target, I would say, where you need the calibration of that machine. So after particular so and so hours, this much is the data or the offset gets created. Okay, so now you have the value of x and you have the values of y, and in future what we are trying to do, we are trying to predict the value of y based on the x. That's what the motive is, and that's what the simple linear regression example we are going to apply. Y is equal to mx plus c. So first thing, what we need to do is, if we have to predict the value of y, we have to know the value of m. M is a slope in mathematics, and in machine learning we call it weight. It is one and the same thing. We have to calculate it. So for that, what is the formula? Very simple formula. It is getting the summation of x of I minus x mean. X mean is nothing but what we have done here. Quickly I will summarize. We have took the addition of this, so it is a sum divided by the count. How much is the count? These are the 5. So 232 divided by 5 will be my 46.4. that's what we have tried to do here. Same way, what we have done, we have took the addition, this is the sum, and we have took the mean. Mean is the average. So how you calculate the average is sum divided by count of the data sets. So here data set is 5, so 6.27 divided by 5 should be 1.254. That's how it has arrived. So now if you see, now we have to calculate, if we are calculating the slope or the weight in machine learning, so the formula is, we have to take the summation of x of I minus x mean. So let's first calculate that part, x of I minus x mean. So what we are trying to do is, we'll first do subtraction of x, 40, minus what is the mean, 46.4. so the outcome is minus 6.4. that's what we have tried to achieve through Excel also. That's what you can see, 40 minus 46.4 is my outcome. Similarly I have done for rest of the values. You can see here, similarly it has been done. 55 minus 46.4 is 8.6. So I have got my first set of equation, x of I minus x mean. Similarly, I will now calculate y of y minus y mean. Same way I have done it. Y of y is nothing but my 1.1 minus y mean. Y mean is 1.254, and it gives me the result. Same way you can see this minus this, and I have the result. So I have done it for rest of the data sets. Now next equation is, we have to multiply it. You can quickly see x of I minus x mean into y of y minus y mean. So what we have done, we have simply multiplied these two values and the outcome is here. Same way these two values and the outcome is here. That's what I'm trying to show you. D7 into E7 is my result. So now I have this handy and in place. So what I have done, I have took the summation of it. That's what my this equation gets completed. So when I took the summation, my outcome is, if I add all these values, my sum is 2.342. So the above part is completed. We have this value. Now what we are trying to do, we just divide it with x of I minus x mean whole square. So you can see what I have tried to do. I already have the value of x of I minus x square. So what I am doing, I am just squaring it. So minus 6.4 whole square. So it is nothing but, you can multiply x of I minus x mean into x of I minus x mean. It is one and the same thing. So you will get the outcome. So what I have done, multiply the same number twice. So it is minus 6.4 into minus 6.4, and outcome is 40.96. Same I have replicated for others. You can quickly see D10 into D10, 8.6 into 8.6, and the result is here. And I have just took the summation of it. Now I have the summation of it. So if I have to calculate the mean, now you guys will tell. If I have to calculate the slope or weight in machine learning, what we need to do is, we have to divide the 2.342 by the summation of x of I minus x mean, that is this value, that is 135.2. If I divide this with this, I will get my slope. That's what we have tried to do. You can see f of 11 divided by g of 11. This is my slope. So now I have my slope calculated. My m value is calculated. That's what I have tried to put. So first part of equation is ready. M of y is equal to mx plus c. So my m is 0.01732249. So this is ready. I have the m value. Now it is very easy for all of us to calculate the y-intercept, called Bayes in machine learning. So what is the formula? Very simple. C is equal to y mean. So what is having, what is our y mean? We already have calculated. It is 1.254. So what we will do, 1.254 minus slope or weight, that is my 0.0173, into x mean. What is my x mean? 46.4. So if you see, that's what we have applied the formula. C of 12, what is C of 12? Yes, y. Y mean is 1.254 minus G15. What is my G15? Quickly, we'll see. G15 is my, the slope, the M value, into B12. What is B12? Is my nothing but the X mean. So that's how my Y intercept is arrived. So my equation, linear regression equation is ready, or the line of fit is ready. So what is the formula? I mean, we have achieved M also, as well as mx plus c, and this is my c value. Now we have to apply it here. Very simple. We have to do m into x plus c. Same way we try to calculate it here. So that's what we have tried to do. We are doing mx plus c. Okay, so now we have got all the five values of mx plus c. This is my line of fit. So now I will try to show you how we can summarize it. Maybe let me do some formatting quickly so that it will. Okay, so okay, sorry, oh my bad, not good in colors. Okay, so now what we did, machine running time we already have. So this is my x, this is my y, and this is the best line of fit. So you can see, if I zoom it, so you can see here, so my best fit of line y, it is going very near to each data point. So this will be my best fit of line. Since I have only 5 data models, you can take 100 200 data sets, then your chart will look more good and you will be able to do some calculations. Ideally, what would you like? You want your line to go very close or directly overlap with the real data points. So that is your best fit of line. But that doesn't happen usually. So I will quickly explain that concept, what we call it. That is called loss, or sometimes people call it cost also. So now you understood we have the best fit of line, but it doesn't mean that it is going to touch each and every data point. So usually what happens, we need to go from multiple iterations. We need to check, is there any data model, is there any prediction that has went wrong. So it trains automatically itself. That is why we have these linear regressions, and in machine learning the models goes into multiple iterations to achieve it. Okay, so let us now quickly go to this section. I would like to explain you what does it mean. So if you see this line properly, so you will be able to see in the first half where you have the x and the y, where you have only one value of x, I would say. So you can see, let's say this is your different data points and this is your prediction, line of prediction. So you can see there is huge difference. So this difference is nothing but the loss, we call it. Okay, this is called the loss. So here the loss is more from the prediction. So this difference. So in this line, by applying linear regression and training the data again and again, the whole concept or motto is to minimize the loss. So for that we have different functions also in place. Okay, so that's what I said. Usually in machine learning algorithms, it tries to build a model by examining many examples and many data. I mean, lot of data it tries to examine, and it tries to attempt to find a model that will minimize the loss. And this process is called by empirical risk minimization. That is the concept through which we minimize the loss, is called empirical risk minimization. So loss is nothing but, I would say, it is a cost or penalty that you are paying for the bad prediction. That is the reason we have some good algorithms also through which we can minimize the loss. We have mean square error. That is not, I mean, we will discuss in our next videos. So we have some algorithms already in place through which we can go to iterative mode and we can calculate the mean square error. We can minimize the loss and get the more predicted value as possible, as much as. Okay, and similarly we have the residual and other things come into picture, but we'll not discuss it as of now. Now I hope till this you have very much clear with machine learning and with our linear regression, how we have calculated the equations, how we have plotted the graph without even using the Python as of now. So same way, now we will try to replicate using the Python code. Let me go to the Anaconda. So this is my Anaconda navigator. This is my environment. Just bear with me, take some time to load. These are the all installed libraries. Since we are plotting, so we are using matplotlib. If you want to install it, you can just type it here. You can go to all, select matplotlib, and you can install it. And then you can go to the home page. You just install the spider. Matplotlib is nothing but the Python code through which you can draw the 2D shapes. So let me launch the spider. Let me click on spider button, launch, and it will launch. And you can see here, we'll go step by step. Very simple. What we have done is we have imported NumPy. NumPy is for mathematical calculations, as I already mentioned in previous videos. Then we have matplotlib. We will be using this library for plotting purpose. So these two libraries are clear, right? So we have the same values. What I'm trying to replicate is whatever values we are having here, same we want to calculate. So my x values are 40, 43, 45, 49, 55, and same way I have the values of y. So if I go to my example, the function starts from something like this. You can see my x and y values has been provided. So my next point comes, get regression coefficient. Regression coefficients are nothing but your bias and weight, or you can say your slope and y-intercept in mathematics. Okay, that's what we are trying to get. So how we get it? Very simple. Let's go to this function, get regression coefficient. Because I have the x and y value, I just need, if you remember, y is equal to mx plus c. So I need the value of m and the c. Or if we talk in terms of machine learning, it is your w1 x1 plus b. B is your bias and w1 is your weight for single input x. So if you we go up slightly, we can see this method, get regression coefficient. So what we are trying to do, first we got the size. So we already know we have a size of 5. So mean x, mean y. Mean is nothing, as we already discussed, it is the average that we took, and there are already methods in NumPy array. You can see has already these methods. We are just giving the value and it will provide us. Similarly, we have done the calculation. It is purely, that's what I have explained in the Excel also. This is your y into x minus mean of this into this divided by that. So this is giving me the slope, or you call the weight, slope of line or the weight. And this is b1, and b0 is my y intercept or bias also, in bias in your machine learning, and y intercept we call it. So we already know the formula is mean of y minus b1 is nothing but your slope into mean x. So now I have both the values readily available, and this function is returning these regression coefficients. Once I have the regression coefficient, I will simply plot the regression line. So we know the regression line is y is equal to mx plus c. I have the m value, I have the c value, or I would say I have the weight, or I have the bias. I will be able to plot my values since I have the x and y values. That's what we are trying to do it in the method. We are using the scatter chart. We use the prediction. You can see my formula here. Simple regression that we have done. b0 plus b1 into x. And if we have multiple inputs, let's say b1x, then it will become b2x, something like that. Since we have only 1x, so that is the reason. It's a simple linear regression formula that we are applying. So we will get the predicted value of y. Then we are simply plotting it, and we are just trying to label x and y, and we are just trying to show it. Now let us try to run it and just focus here what will happen, and then we'll compare it with our Excel, because in Excel we have done it manually by using Excel formulas. It should completely match with the Excel outcome. So let's run it. Okay, just bear with me for a couple of more minutes. We are almost done. So you can see here b0 or y intercept or bias, we have got 0.45. so let us go to our example. So bias in machine learning or y intercept is 0.45, and the slope or weight is 0.017. So the slope or weight is 0.017 and the intercept is 0.45. based on that, it has drawn the same line that we have tried to fit. So looking at the model, you can see here it is not completely, there is some loss. Definitely we can see there is some loss, but it is the one of the best fit line. So if we go for 6 to 7 different iterations or 10 to different iterations and apply some more, since maybe I will try to explain in our subsequent videos, when we apply some residual, or we will do some apply some loss or cost functions, then we can minimize the loss. That's what we would like to achieve it. And maybe in my next video I will try to show you the multilinear regression. Even you can also try it. Now it is the foundation, that your bases are clear, you can try it multilinear regression also, through which you can, rather than going for the residual or the mean loss, you can even use the normalization also. Normalization is also one of the concepts through which you eliminate the loss. That's what we try to achieve. So again, regression is not the only algorithm that we use, since you have already studied in mathematics. To start with machine learning, we use the regression. If there is no linear relationship between the data, so it doesn't make sense to use a linear regression. But for that, we have different kind of algorithms readily available that we can use. So as quickly I would, since we have wrote this code from scratch, we can do similar kind of thing. You can see in my next example. Let me clear this so that you won't get confused. So you can see here what we have done is same. We have imported the numP, okay, and we have plotted the imported this library. And what I have done is I have directly imported the linear regression functions or the model from sklearn.linearModel. So this is readily available. I have already installed it. So you can also go and do it. So now here what I am doing, I am creating the object of linear regression. I am just passing the x and y. Before passing, since it is an array, we need to create it into the matrix. That is the reason I am just trying to reshape it 1 to 5 array. Now I am trying to fit the model with the values x and y, and I will be just plotting it and it will predict the values. So let me try to run it. So you can see I have, yes, it has done the trick. So if I write a few more lines of code, it will plot that line. So it has given me the desired output. So you can see it has saved a lot of time. When it predicts internally, it uses the same regression technologies or the methods that we have written. Rather than writing from scratch, you can directly go and use the available libraries. But to give the holistic view, I thought it is better to help you in understanding from step by step process and from scratch. So one last thing, you can go to Scikit Learn, you can install it, you can go to the linear regression, you will get some ready-made code also available. You can play around with it. There are lot of examples already for linear regression available. Just try to do some hands-on and it should be fine. So thank you for watching this video. I would appreciate if you will subscribe to the channel or share this video in your group. So you are now one step ahead than others for becoming a data scientist. Welcome in the gang. Okay, thank you. Thanks a lot. Namaste.